In this video, we will learn how to use markers. Markers provide you with the possibility of getting fast information for a selected area on the graph. First of all, select the Markers tab. You can see the markers as two red lines. To move the markers, place the mouse cursor on one of the thick lines, like this or this. You can see the first marker is called X1, the last marker is called X2. By clicking on the marker and dragging and dropping, you can move the marker to the required position. In the markers list, the individual values at the marker and the difference between the x-axis and the y-axis are shown in the list. If you click on the name in the graph, this is highlighted in the markers list. The x-axis can be zoomed by clicking on the axis and using the mouse wheel. If you move it backwards, it zooms in. If you move the mouse wheel forwards, it zooms out. By clicking on the x-axis and moving the mouse to the right or to the left, you can move the position of the x-axis. The same on the y-axis. You click on it and then use the mouse wheel to zoom in, going backwards or zoom out, turning forwards to get the required resolution. It is also possible by clicking on the y-axis and shifting up, down to change the position. It is also possible to zoom into a particular area by clicking the left mouse button at the start in the upper left-hand corner of the zoom area, dragging and dropping the bottom right-hand corner of the zoom area, and then releasing the mouse button. There are three zoom out functions. The first is the one-level zoom out. Click on this and the x-axis will go back one step. I will zoom in again. The second function is to zoom out completely and the x-axis returns to the original value. There is a similar function for the y-axis. Right-click on the y-axis, select Auto Scale Axis, and this returns the y-axis to the original scale. If you want to do precision marking, then click on the thick part of the marker, select Control. If you move to the left, the marker automatically moves to the first point of a particular y-value. If you move to the right, you'll move to the next first point of the next y-value. It is also possible to show the precise length of a pulse or a gap time. To do this, double-click on the required pulse or gap. Then you see the length is displayed, in seconds in this case. Again, trying this for a gap. You see again, the length is displayed. This can be applied for each graph. To delete the display, again double-click on the required pulse or gap. You can also see the statistics of the areas selected by the markers. Select the Statistics tab and you can see the important characteristics of the XY and the X2 values. We have the minimum, the maximum, the average and the standard deviation of each signal.